And we are underway for JFK versus Sayreville in a GMC white division matchup. Goes out on the far sideline. It'll maintain the Mustangs possession. And referee signaling that it'll go to about the 35-yard line. Mustang kicks it up high. Coming down with it is three. Over to Diaz. Now to the back line, Restaro. Restaro going to the center. Miranda. Headed back to Diaz. The left center back. Oops, Collymore tries to send Osorio on the far side. And it'll be scooped up by Trevetti.
Osorio really does have that speed. So that would be a great idea to keep sending balls over the top of the defense. Hopefully it'll work later on in the game.
Trying to head it down, Gumase now coming over midfield. Lopes trying to run after it. Lopes on the left wing, inside the box. Still with it. Going off Restaro's head. And three will boot it up.
So far, JFK is coming out good, pressuring whenever they can. That's a really good way to start off, especially against a strong team like Sayreville.
And here comes player with a catch. Here's 11 on the chase. And Sandor is able to pick it up and give it out to Gumase.
Gumase needs to play a lot quicker than that.
And over here went out of bounds on number 6, Pereira. Pereira. Still in Mustang's possession. It'll be a free kick taken by Gumase. Looking to switch fields. Got a man in the middle. Collymore. Going off of number 3, Brooks. Intended receiver was Restaro. Still fighting for it on the near sideline, and it goes off Lopes now. Here's the throw to Brooks. Going off Brooks. Here comes the right back, Sayreville.
Sayreville should really be looking to switch fields on this because they've got everyone clogging the sides, and so far in each throwing, JFK has been doubling up their man marks.
Going off the head of Rockwall. Here's Diaz.
That was a really great look.
Trying to send it up to 11, Maldonado.
Maldonado is looking to take a quick corner. Oh no, but he lets his fellow teammate take it.
It looks like Maldonado is playing as a left forward today. He's usually the top scorer, I believe, for Sayreville. Here's the cross, going over Maldonado, over to Brooks. Brooks trying to send it inside, booted away by Lipinski. Here comes Lopes on the left wing. Three defenders to beat. Switching it into the middle, here's Osorio, 35-yard line, guarded by Brooks. Does a nice move, jukes out to the left wing. Inside the box, still pushed down the left wing. Here comes Gumase trailing behind him, trying to send it in. Tried to clear it was number 21, O'Connor. That'll be scooped up by Trevetti. Punts it downfield. Now Lipinski's there with the header. Right wing is Brooks.
Brooks attempted a early cross, but it went right off of Gumase.
Headed out by Lipinski again. And the Brooks. Sorry, that's number 10. Still playing around with it. In the middle. Here's a shot by Maldonado! And about 20 yards out, he rifles it into the upper 90s on the right side for the first goal of the game. Great shot by Maldonado.
That was a power shot. Sailed right over Sandor's head. He barely got a hand on it, but it wasn't enough to knock it out. Back of the net.
He was standing a little off to the left, beyond the 18, and just fired one.
Yep,
good job by
90.
Him.
Let's see if JFK can get back from this one. They're not shying away from sending their forwards up.
There's Restaro trying to send it inside to Lopes. Here comes Osorio. Osorio still with it. Finds himself in a corner. Miranda got a touch on it, but it's going to be taken out. And then Brooks not able to catch up to it. And now Gumase will come in for the throw. Only 5 minutes into this one, we already have the first goal of the game. Restaro goes down. Trying to send it inside. Deflected out. Diaz is there with it. Again, into the center. Going off Maldonado. Coach Miggett signaling for offside on 7. Tries to send it up. Here comes Brooks on the right wing. He's open. He's got space to work with.
Good pass.
They're
trying to string together some passes connecting with their teammates before they look towards goal.
There's a shot. And it was a good attempt to no avail. And now Sandor will look to clear it.
This is really good to see Sayreville taking so many shots so early. The more shots they'll get, the more comfortable they'll get with their surroundings, and the closer they'll get to getting another one.
And they're going to call a foul from behind on Restaro, one of the more aggressive players for the Mustangs. He got a few tackles the other day against Perth Amboy. Inside. Tries it. And Sandor is able to recover it. Boots it downfield over to the midfield. Collymore contesting it. There's Maldonado sending it inside. Has a man off the back heel. Still inside left corner. Here's 7 with it. 7 tries a shot. Can't get a strong foot to it.
Sandor's there for the easy shot scoop. By Barbosa. We saw him running up the left wing earlier, but he wasn't able to pull off the shot.
Off Lopes. Here's it on the near sideline, over to midfield. Here's Collymore. Challenged by Maldonado. Goes off of Maldonado. Now Gumase looking to Miranda. Got some space in the middle. Now he's guarded by two defenders.
Miranda really should have switched that sooner. He had a defender running up the right wing on the other side.
Here it is. It's intercepted by Sayreville. Here's the cross to Maldonado.
Oh, great pass.
Good pass. Inside the left side of the box.
Ooh.
And he takes his shot on that one. It's a bit high. Going off the uprights of the field goal post.
Yeah, barely soared over the crossbar. If that had, if he had just lowered it a little bit, it would have been a goal.
And you see Sayreville getting their crisp passes here in the first.
Sanders' goal kick went right back to him after coming off of a blue shirt.
And it'll go off of Brooks on the right wing. And Gumase has it now. Going off the right back rock wall.
Yeah, Sayreville's defense is just going to keep knocking it out and messing with the flow that JFK is trying to build.
And Gumase tried to get too many free yards on that one. You know a little about that, huh? Lopes. Brooks, now guarded by Restaro. And Restaro will have it at about the 10-yard line. Throws it into Gumase. Trying to give it back to him. Over to Collymore. 25-yard line. Rostaro in the center. At about center half. Now over to 10. Here's Lipinski.
Good idea to send it over the Sayreville defense towards Lopes, but Lopes is a little more far right for the ball that that Lipinski send over the left side.
And now here's Trevetti clearing it. Trying to send Maldonado, and by a hair, it looked like he was offside. It looked like that was pretty clean.
Arm, he's got these long limbs, and it just got past the defense.
Trying to send it up. Acer. Here's Osorio. Kicking out. And as Acer kicked it out, looks to be one of the captains on the teams. It ricocheted off of Rostaro. And now we'll see a throw in by number 13, Gates. Still working with it. Susa tried to get it before. Almost sent Maldonado. It's off of Diaz. Still trying to find him.
It's like the Mustangs have no midfield right now. Each time Sayreville gathers the people in the middle, send it right to the Mustangs defense. And there's no white shirts in the middle to clean up and help out.
Guarded tightly by Gumase. Almost gets it over to Maldonado. Out of bounds. Mustang throw in. Mustangs now pinned in their own half. Here's the header.
Wide open.
Gets it over to Barbosa. Barbosa.
He goes and tries to shoot it, but it goes way out. Didn't even lift it off the ground.
It looked like a shot and a pass at the same time.
Yeah, I couldn't make up his mind.
He might have seen the goal and then saw his teammate. Sometimes that happens in basketball when you take a shot. You're not sure if you want to just hit it right into the hoop or go off the backboard. And that ultimately just alters the shot. Gumase.
Mustangs are really struggling to get up out of their end. And Sayreville is just knocking them back down.
And Lopes tried to chase it. Still a white ball. Gates is going to run back on defense. Gumase again. Usually winds up taking most of the throw-ins throughout the game since he is the left back.
Yeah, Gumase is very good at sneaking up the side, getting an extra 5 yards on the throw, but the ref spotted it early. He's going to keep his eye on him for the rest of the game with these throw-ins.
And they call a foul on Llorente. So it'll be free kick. Here's Miranda. Miranda at the 10, still with it, taking everyone on in the center.
And he just stands around everybody from the midfield to the back of the defense, and he was one-on-one with the goalie, but he just had to get a little touch off, but he was waiting for him.
That was some fancy footwork there. And now here's a push by Sayreville. Going over to Sandor. Miranda. Here comes Llorente. Llorente. Lipinski. Osorio. Here comes Llorente again. Now Acer. Miranda can't get to it. Llorente off of Collimore.
Yeah, Miranda's too prone to taking too many touches when he should have just laid off the ball. This is part of the problem with the midfield, why they can't get up.
And it'll be Sayreville throwing. Taking it, number 6, Pereira. Taking a nice long stride. Way inside the field. It's in the middle. Collymore looking to clear it.
Wow, that was a long throw. It basically was like taking a corner kick.
And Osorio tried to chase it before it went out of bounds on the far sideline at about the 20. It was a good attempt by Osorio. He knew that if he got that ball, it would have been wide open downfield. Going over Maldonado. Sandor, easy scoop once again. Sayreville hasn't had, I'd say, too many shot attempts. But the one that they really got was the one that went in. Maldonado.
Yeah, a good way to start off the game. Knock a goal in early.
Here they come. Trying to send it inside.
Diaz knocks it away easily.
Still working. Gumase gets him from behind, and now seven. Barbosa off the head. Switching fields. Llorente gives it off to Acer, the midfielder, and it's sent up again by Lipinski. Loeb's trying to fight with it. And I'm not sure what happened there, but 13 Gates went down on the play. It didn't look like Lopes pushed him. What do you think?
Yeah, he threw a little elbow in there, but it was nothing he wasn't receiving in return. It was 1v2, so he had to get a little aggressive. Don't blame him for trying.
Bouncing around, Lipinski. Over to Barbosa. Barbosa! And Lipinski's there once again.
Now, Barbosa, whenever he has the ball in the center, the first thing he does is look up at goal, and he's trying to get one past Sandor.
Mustangs reset. Sandor gets it off. On the far sideline at the midfield, Barbosa.
Miranda just gets a touch.
Picks it off.
Going on for goal.
Here's Miranda. Off the crossbar. Off the woodwork. Couldn't get it to go. One of the best looks that they've had so far today.
Yes, they're both scrambling with the counterattack now. They really want to catch Mustangs off guard.
There's Osorio at the midfield. Getting his number five. Now Barbosa lays it off to him. Surging forward. Maldonado comes away with it, but then Lipinski's on it. Trying to send it up. Here comes Rockwall. Llorente. Restaro. Guarding him like a glove. Still comes away with it.
Yeah, he's got Lopes. Quick feet. Great for marking back on defense when he's caught up.
Kicks it out. But that was a surge of momentum in both teams right there. Here comes Collymore.
Comes forward.
Knocking down Rockwall.
Taking down everything in his path.
Rockwall, one of the bigger players on the team. And now he lays it off. And it goes out of bounds. Looked like that was also Rockwall. I'm sorry, before that was Gates in the defense. But anyway, here's Llorente sending it. Goes over to the Mendez, but he's fighting with it. Barbosa takes him down, no call. Here's Lipinski. Here's a few jukes by Lipinski.
Wow, he's just cutting by everybody.
Lipinski still with it. Trying to send Lopes. Not close enough, and now Trivedi.
That was a really good run by Lipinski. He took it all the way off of Barbosa on defense and ran it up the right side, crossed it through the middle, and distributed well for Lopes up top.
And Gates will kick it out.
Gumase inching forward. Got about 3 yards on that.
Let's see how much more he goes.
This is why they have him taking the throw in.
Yeah, definitely not afraid to take a little more. Looks like we have players that are ready to sub in for Sayreville number 18. Barreiro. And number 19. Colon. Good move by Acer. Up in the air. Miranda. Here comes Acer.
Laying it off for Barbosa.
And Mendez puts a little bit of a box out on him so he can't come away with it. But Barbosa has it once again. Acer. Maldonado. Lipinski. over into the midfield. That's there.
Went straight through the center midfield. And this is where Mustangs are failing. It's like they have no center mid.
Here's a wide open man on the right wing. And as he fired it, Lipinski's there to deflect the shot.
Lipinski looked like he was shot out of cannon, came all the way from the other side of the field, and he just rocketed forward and knocked the ball out.
Corner. Yeah, Lipinski, we just saw him over in the midfield about 4 seconds ago.
Yeah. Yes, we did.
Part of your job as a center back.
Yeah, you could tell he's their main center back. Mustangs hold strong on defense with him there. Without him, there would probably be a lot more goals right now.
Here's the corner by Barbosa. There's a shot, not a good one.
Probably Moore kicks it out.
Trying to get to it, but now Lopes.
Mustangs are really slow to go out and join their forwards.
And trying to give him the advantage, but they're complaining about the call on that one. I'm sure Migas might regret arguing that one, but it'll be Mustang ball at the 35. Tried to take it at the 45. Again, trying to get some free yards.
Lipinski with the kick.
Now here it comes. Over to Lopes. Sarah's still with it. Over into center, goes by the midfielder, Miranda.
Miranda knocks it forward for Lopes.
Oh,
Lopes trying to use
Lopes.
His speed.
Here's Lopes, oh.
Almost a mess up with the back pass towards the goalie, but he was there to meet. It's a good thing Chivetti's not falling asleep here, otherwise that would have been very bad.
And it dribbles out of bounds. Collymore not able to get to it. There's Gumuse off of Gates. Trying to send the forward, Diaz. Far side. Number 5 to Barbosa.
Good leading pass.
And going out of bounds, but now we'll see Mendez with the throw. And Mendez hasn't really been a factor in this game. But he is one of the more important players for the Mustangs. There's a shot. Far right.
That was really scary for the back four there.
Sayreville starting to look frustrated, not getting shots anymore.
Yeah, that was basically wrapped up and gifted for the Sayreville forwards. They should have hit the back of the net or at least try to get a shot on target. Sander didn't even have to do anything.
With sparkles and pretty paper, would you say?
Yeah, gift wrapped birthday kit. That came early.
And number 6, one of the captains, Pereira, gets taken out on the near sideline, but it'll be a throw-in for them. Winding up into the middle, off Maldonado. Now here comes Lipinski, surging forward. See how much speed he has, blazing the trail.
Wow, he just uses his speed.
Still going forward. He's taking it himself.
Looking for Lopes in the center.
Trying to send it up to the middle. Got four Mustangs back deep. Lipinski, center. Not the pass he wanted. And now it's a foot race with Barbosa. Barbosa! And he gets it over the head of Sandor for a far goal for the Bombers.
Yeah, it's a good thing he had his head up. He saw Sandor was 15 yards out of his line, and he just chipped it right over. Good placement.
Bombs away for Barbosa. Good play for them. It looked like the Mustangs had a problem clearing the ball when it came back to them. Didn't get a good foot on it. What did you see?
You know what happened? I saw Lipinski took it all the way up, and like I mentioned before, he's their main man on defense, and Collymore was covering, but right when they went to switch back, that's where the Sayreville forwards took advantage. Slid it right past them while they switch and sending Barbosa on.
That shot almost reminded me of David Villa's shot against Honduras in the 2010 World Cup. when they left via wide open as a goalkeeper came out.
You know what it reminded me of? Carly Lloyd, went, like her third goal against Japan in the Women's World Cup over the summer. Far shot, but that was...
That was a superlative shot, but it does come close, I guess, at the high school level. Off the head of 14. Here's Osorio. Trying to fight with it. And Acer is going to run into number 12, Solano.
That's like one of the first times we actually saw him coming and meeting the ball in the midfield. Hopefully we see more of him so Sayreville doesn't get past too easy.
Osorio tried to send his man in the middle, Collymore with the header.
Osorio takes too many catches sometimes. When you're standing inside the box and you have the chance to look up the goal, the best thing to do is take the shot.
No, that was actually a good send by Collymore. Rastall almost got a foot to it, but we have a player who goes down on the field and we'll have an official timeout. Sorry for the technical difficulties. And now we're back. About 5 minutes remaining in the first half of play.
And the score is still 2-0 Sayreville.
Trying to stick with it. 21. Ooh, Miranda good. Goes around him.
Miranda.
Here's Osorio. Osorio.
They really shouldn't lose it with two people guarding the defender.
O'Connor was the one who was challenging him. And our Mustangs are pushing forward. Gumase over to Miranda. Gumase. Over to 14. Ola Oko. Trying to run onto it. Sandor boots it over to us. And it somehow goes right back into play, miraculously.
It's a good thing Sander was ready, waiting for the ball, because otherwise that would have ended bad with miscommunication between Lipinski and Sandor.
And now we're waiting for 14 once again. And
wow, his throw-in reached the goalie.
It went right to the goalie from about the 25-yard line. Pretty good thrower. Far sideline. Osorio tries to track it down. Osorio working with it. Here comes Solano. Ooh, knocks over Lopes. Here's Miranda. Knocks into Trevetti on the ground.
Miranda
is going to trip up O'Connor.
I kind of feel like that should have been foul, the one that where that, they push Lopes.
That could have, that should have been, that might have been a foul, yeah. Or even with Miranda running into Trevetti.
Maybe he was allowing like a opportunity playing on since he saw Miranda shine up top.
Pushing it forward on the far sideline, and he'll just kick it out.
Not sure. It just got really hot out.
Yeah.
Like 10 degrees
hotter. Sun is beating down on us.
And you know, the turf heats up fast like an oven. So these players must be sweating. Bullets.
I'm sweating. I'm not even moving. Chips him up. Gonna play on. There's a cross into the middle. A header! And it was a pretty accurate pass, not an accurate shot.
Going off the head of Maldonado. That cross going in is really good though. It curved right to the player up top. And we'll see Stelska coming in.
Stelska. And going out of bounds, it'll be Sayreville throwing. Going off Lipinski. Lipinski pins it over in the far sideline again. Here's a throw in at the 20. trying to find his man into the center, up in the air. Miranda, not able to corral it. Still fighting for it. Mendez in the center, here's Miranda. Tries to cut right, lays it off to Miranda. Miranda looking for Lopes. Lopes turns the corner and runs. And it's a good slide tackle by O'Connor. O'Connor, one of the center backs. We've seen him in, all over the field as well. Here's Miranda to Mendez. Back to Lopes. Lopes turns to the right. Tries to cross it to no avail. And Solano will have it. Lets it go over to Lipinski. Lipinski boots it. Switching fields.
Yeah, that was a really good try to switch fields, but the left side was not ready for it. They should have been waiting on the line, really.
And with that, we will end the first half of play. Sayreville up 2-0. And we're here in the second half of play on the near sideline. Number 5, one of the center backs for Sayreville will have the kick. That's Mosa. Here's the boot inside. Here's Brooks going off of Diaz, trying to have it. Brooks inside, good slide tackle by Restaro, but he finds Barbosa on the open sideline, dukes it, and it's far over the goal.
Now the Mustangs seem really disorganized. It looks like they're scrambling around in the defense just now. That's not a good way to be starting off the second half.
And I'll see Sandor line up to take the goal kick. Coming over, headed over by Diaz, and now Sandor tries to whip it out. Frieda Witzer, or Selska. Here's Miranda near sideline, and it just goes out of bounds. Selska not able to save it. Cuts inside, Maldonado tries a shot, and it's far wide. A bit ill-advised on that one.
Yeah, he actually had some more time to go get his head up and set up for it. But you could tell he just wanted to get a shot off.
Mustangs coming to this game 1-4 on the season. They've been shut out in the last two games against Perth Amboy and New Brunswick. Still not with the score on the board. Having it on the far sideline. Six looking across it. Inside, into the middle. Here's a shot deflected by Lipinski. Trying to send it again inside. Head off by Seselka. Replacing Gumise. Brooks! I'm sorry, that's Acer. And Acer not able to connect on that one. Sailing out of bounds.
Sandor backing up to take the goal kick.
Still with it, trying to find a man inside. Couldn't get it to Maldonado, but Diaz kicks it up. Barbosa trying to send the captain, Pereira. Pereira. Let's see what the call is. No official call has been made. And Sayreville will set up with a corner on their own. It looks like it's going to be Barbosa again taking it.
Small pass.
Yeah, it's a quick pass to Pereira.
Barbosa going to shoot way over.
And you can tell that Barbosa loves to bomb it away like a Sayreville bomber.
Sayreville.
Playing for the Wright High School. Bombed it away. Maybe that shot would have went in if he was standing 40 yards out again. But not this time. About 10 yards off goal.
But still, he single-handedly still has more shots than the Kennedy Mustangs do all together as a team.
That is true. As the Mustangs have been struggling to get the ball upfield in the second half.
Yeah, even with all these goal kicks by Sandor and him being able to punt it up, they still haven't been able to get it out of their end.
All right, here's Miranda going over midfield. trying to send Lopes. Lopes gonna get bumped off his mark by Musa. There's a shot by Osorio, and it's gonna be cleared off the back line by Acer. Here's a throw in by Mendez. Over to Solano. Mendez, far sideline. Trying to work with it. Still bouncing around in the middle, and it's gone out of bounds, and it'll be a corner kick for the Mustangs. Mustangs working with it.
Lipinski sending it in.
Going over Collymore. Brooks gets a foot to it.
Lipinski gets packed just in time.
Osorio looking for Lopes. Fighting for it. Mendez gets chipped up by Barbosa. And they'll give them a free kick.
Let's see if they can make something off of this free kick.
Trying to send it in to Solano.
Lopes is all the way in the far corner, trying to gain possession.
Good job by Mosa. Going off of Brooks. Kennedy has some good field position now. Here's Miranda. Looking for Lopes. Clearing it way downfield. And Maldonado has a breakaway, beats defenders in front of Lipinski and into the left side of the goal. Second goal of the game for Maldonado, and it's the third goal for the Sayreville Bombers. Great job sending Maldonado. He was inside midfield, and he just had two defenders to beat, got past them with the speed.
Yeah, Diaz and Lipinski got caught way up on Sayreville's half. Completely forgot Maldonado was there, most likely. And the ball just sailed over, and it was a foot race for goal.
Sayreville. Unfortunate for the Mustangs, had all their players pushed up. No one was able to run back on defense. It is a hot day today, a scorcher. Starting to heat up. As we'll try to send Maldonado again inside the right side, taking away is Lipinski. Here comes Acer, midfielder, sending it up, and it'll be corralled by Sandor. Going off for Star, here's Llorente. Musa finding Maldonado, tries to send it over to Pereira. Going down with it, Soselka. Not too much of a clearance. Llorente trying to fight off Restaro. And it'll be a foul on Llorente as foul was committed on Restaro. And now we see Pereira talking about holding on his side. Hey, 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 hey. Like Mr. Ed. Here's the kick by Diaz.
Go straight to Miranda, looking to turn. Unable to get past his mark. Passes it back to Lipinski.
Hey, you want to do
play-by-play? Loses it.
Do play-by-play.
Barbosa looking up. And it gets stopped by Mendez. He sends it over to Osorio, who loses it, taking too many touches. Great slide out by Lipinski. Gains back Mustang possession.
I know, but just...
Long throw going way over the defense, all the way to Maldonado. Now it's Barbosa looking at goal. You could tell he wants to shoot it. And Sanders scoops it up off of a deflection of his own defender.
Yeah, it wasn't too strong of a shot by Barbosa. Just, again, Barbosa bombs away, just trying to send something up. He's looking anxious.
Yeah, pretty soon he's going to get a shot that's actually on target, and they're most likely going to get a goal off of a deflection off of a Kennedy defense. See Mendez really holding on to that defender.
Off of Mosa. Mosa's tripped Mosa up. And now he'll have a free kick at about the 45.
Goes over Diaz's head.
Are you serious?
Now we have Osaro coming up the right side, trying to use his speed to get past the defense. Sends Miranda, but it goes out for a Kennedy kick. Throw in.
Okay. And now Kennedy taking their time with this one, trying to get their players restored. They look tired out there, not moving around too much. It is a hot day. You can imagine if their energy has been spent already, about 11 minutes into the second half.
Yeah, and they're losing hope. They weren't able to get one all throughout the first half, and they're already down 3-0. It doesn't look good, chance-wise.
Still trying to work it up. Can't lose hope. Gotta keep fighting. Gotta play to the whistle. Here's Solano.
Trying for a shot. It's been the first one in a while, and it was not on target.
Well, at least Solano
doesn't have to worry, yeah, that's for sure.
We've seen Solano taking some shots in the midfield. Hasn't been moving a lot too much. Not a really agile player, but we've seen him taking his own shots as they've been leaving him open. And who knows, maybe one of those will connect later on.
It seems like that will be their best opportunity, since whenever they send their forwards, they get stopped in the corner with no angle. So their best opportunity might be taking shots in the midfield.
Go, go, go!
Oh, and Sander just got beat. Goal for Sayreville Bombers. Really easy. It just came right off the side, straight to the defenders, but no defenders were able to kick it out. Blue shirt wide open in the middle, and he knocked it in easy.
Yeah,
and
easy.
That was Pereira.
No, it was an easy goal. I don't think it was Pereira, but on that play, as it comes over, it looks like it was still can't get a read on his number. I think it was number 8, Sousa, on the play. Great job by Sousa getting past Sandor, just
and
chipping it over.
And now it's 4-0.
No, you have to learn how to do it. And going out of bounds, it'll be a throw in for the Mustangs. Mustang thrown by Mendez. Now here's Lipinski over to Collymore. Here's a Sayre who's able to get a touch onto it. Trying to fend his man again. It's Sosa! And Sosa again chips it in with the left foot on the right side, and now it's 5-0 Sayreville. Great play by Sayreville.
Once he got past the defense, all he had to do was poke it into the far side, and Sander wasn't even ready for it. 5-0 Sayreville.
And we see it's already 5-0. Sousa's gonna come out and has the substitute number 4, Salgado, coming in for him. As Sousa had 2 back-to-back goals within about 3 minutes of time.
Now we see that JFK is just trying to send up the balls whenever they have possession and hopefully get the whole team up with them. Hasn't been working so far, but it's the only opportunities they have to get up into Sayreville's end.
Headed away. Sayre switching fields.
Sending Maldonado.
Maldonado. Here's 24 with it for the Mustangs. Go We'll see some of the backup players into the game. That was Milton. Mendez sending it up. Intended target was Miranda. Miranda gonna try to steal it. And going out of bounds, it'll be a throw-in for Sayreville. Working on that far sideline. Here's Milton. Milton booting it out of bounds. Didn't have pressure, not sure why he did that. But it'll be a Sayreville throw-in again. Here's the left back. Maldonado gets taken down by Milton. Here comes number four, Salgado. Salgado crossing it in. No one there on the play. Looked like he was looking for Pereira, trying to run in. Just out of reach. Now Sandor boots it downfield. Lopes can't get a foot to it. Llorente steals it away.
Yeah, and Lopes had no help there. It was just him against two of Sayreville. And the other forwards just watched.
There's Mosa. As Restaro is able to get a foot onto it. Going out of bounds, Llorente comes here on the near sideline. Mosa. Trying to find Maldonado.
Get it out! Win the ball!
Trying to get it out, Restaro.
Good job!
Here's Miranda. Miranda switches it over to Solano. Can't get it to Osorio. It's kicked back up by Sayreville. Here's Pereira. And Maldonado, he knows he's offside. Doesn't get a foot to it.
We see that Kennedy can even string together three passes, even when they're wide open in the midfield.
Acer going off Solano. Acer gets it right back. Near sideline, center half. There comes Llorente. And here's a unnecessary push. Here's a frustration foul by Miranda. Llorente jumps right back up, and it'll be a free kick at about the 27-yard line. Mustangs looking exhausted and out of this game. Look like they just want to finish it and get it over with.
Yeah, after this deficit, it's not going to be easy.
Yeah, no heart anymore.
You see Colgan looking who he's going to take the cross to.
It's a small wall of Miranda and Restaro, about 10 yards out. Takes it with the left boot. Over to Pereira, goes over his head, and Milton's going to try to chase it, and he lets it go out of bounds. It'll be a goal kick for Sandor. And we'll see Barbosa coming back into the game, playing on the left wing. We'll see another fresh face for Sayreville. Looks like that's number 18, Barrera. Sending it up off of Mendez.
Solano's struggling to get back possession. It's out for a Sayreville throw. Each time on these throw-ins, they just keep looking for Maldonado up top, who does a pretty good job maintaining Sayreville possession.
Yeah, does a good job of getting open. Does a pretty decent job of drawing defenders and leaving his teammates open for good looks at the goal. Milton with the header. Now we see Milton running around. He's got lots of energy. He was not put into the game throughout the first half, but now we see that he's getting his first touches in the second half, and now he'll have the energy that Kennedy needs.
Yeah, we're going to see a lot of him considering Kennedy is constantly on defense.
Across Sandor. Goes over to the kicker, Barbosa, trying to get it in. It's dangerous. Inside, Sandor blocks it, and here's Milton trying to clear it. Taken away by Miranda. Here's three JFK forwards pushing it up. Lopes has a strategy of kicking the ball in front of him to try to run onto it, but it hasn't been working today.
Yeah, he's been trying to use his speed to get around the defense, but it doesn't work when the defense is just as fast as you are.
And perhaps even faster, not even getting any
gain on them. Yeah, I haven't seen him get around the left back on Sayreville's side.
And that's when dribbling skills come into play.
Yeah, and passing usually works, but there's usually never anyone there up top supporting Kennedy's forwards.
Sario on the right wing.
Nice
cuts
cut.
Inside. There's a temp. Sario! And it's going to be hauled in by Trevetti. But that was a good attempt by Osorio.
Trevetti hasn't had to do much throughout the game, but he did a good job coming out. He's not rusty.
And then the one you passed off, and I'm like, I bet you she thought she was going to kick it right to the goalie. So she passed.
Looking up, Milton gets ahead to it. Barbosa. Going to try to send his man, number 12.
Cuito.
The new substitute. Here's Diaz still fighting with it. Miranda lays it off to Solano, right wing. And going off of, looks like Rockwell on that play. The Rockwell certainly over there, not letting JFK do anything on that right, on the left sideline.
There's
Mendez. Osorio. Osorio runs into two defenders.
Milton.
Going off Cuito. And it'll go out of bounds near sideline. 40-yard line. We're going to see
Lipinski's back in.
Yeah, Lipinski coming back in. Milton coming out. Milton did a good job replacing Lipinski in the center, giving him a quick breather.
Yeah, it was good to see fresh legs. And now that Lipinski had a chance to rest after all the running around he did in the first half, I guarantee you he's going to be looking with an offensive pair of eyes. He's going to be trying to bring the ball himself.
Yeah, look, in the first half we saw him with a burst of speed that went up the sideline, and now here comes Sayreville. There's Maldonado, left wing, and it's just right of the goal. Almost put it in for another goal for his team.
Yeah, he didn't miss by much. Great look at goal, great shot, and he might get another one before this game ends.
And that was a beautiful pass by number 14, Opie Olaloco. Olaloco. That'd be an insult in Spanish, but here's Maldonado, far sideline. Left wing, trying to cut inside. Has a man inside a box. Kicked out by Diaz. Osorio trying to chase it down on the far sideline. It's taken away by Rockwell. Miranda, midfield. Looking for an opening. Barbosa can't get to it. Miranda stepping over it. Booted out.
Diaz is always caught too far up. Every single time we've seen him in the second half, the ball's sailing over his head, which really doesn't help him with his height.
Yeah, all right. Sasalka is calling more now. Barbosa again. Here's Olaloco. Maldonado. Far sideline. Barbosa! And it's a good cannon right into Sandor's hands. Restaro. Coming in Sosa. So that was Salgado. Olaloco. With the strong defense. Tries a shot of his own. Goes far right of the goal.
Yeah, everyone on this Sayreville Bombers team is getting a shot on Sandor today.
Yeah, Sandor working overtime these past three games. He can only save so many. Olaloco. And it'll go out of bounds off that Mendez kick. Sayreville will have it at about midfield. And we're going to see Gumase come back into the game. And we'll see 19 for Sayreville coming out. Colgan working on the right sideline. Tries it inside. Lipinski's there to stop it. Diaz doesn't get a good foot to it. Here's the shot.
Weak clearance. It went straight on the ground. Set up like a pass for that forward. Oh, Loco had a great attempt off of Diaz's sad clearance.
Yeah, Diaz just couldn't get a good foot to it. You know, it happens. Sometimes you mistime these things.
Yeah, but on defense, that's costly.
I really hope so this course. Like, I really hope so this course. Dude, I take these
Stevens. Wait. Yo, 5-0. What if Fern has a great hat-trick in a row? Please tell me Fern has a hat-trick again.
No, it's only a second. Oh, sure. Lipinski. Mosa. Selka. Challenged by Quito. And referee will award the Mustangs with the throw-in. Selka trying to get something started here. Diaz with the boot. Barbosa. Miranda.
Miranda. Pass off to Lopes.
And again, just running into the slew of Sayreville Bombers. Not looking for a teammate, just.
We saw Miranda and Quito kicking each other deliberately.
And now. Mustangs have a free kick at about the 25-yard line. And Miranda will set up for it as Colin Morris starts running into the box to set up.
JFK. You see Diaz running as well. He wants to get some action.
Miranda.
That's it.
And here's Barbosa. Barbosa all over the field, switching to any side the ball is on. Solano kicked up by Geeks. Maldonado almost got to it. And now we see on the far side, it's a foot race between Mendez. Maldonado turns.
Ooh, Collymore takes him down with his elbow.
Collymore takes him down. Using that body. Several fans asking, where's the yellow card? But anyway, Sayreville will set up with good positioning. Straight on! And that one sails way out of bounds.
Bombs it over.
Another bomb for the Bombers. They have to adjust that cannon that they're firing. Going too far over the goals. It's a hot one today. It's
only getting hotter.
Yeah, only getting hotter, and this sun is beating down. There's no wind. You can imagine how hot these players must be. And we're 27 minutes into the second half. 13 minutes to go. 5-0 Sayreville. Here's a throw into Diaz.
Collymore steps forward, looking to send Rosaro. Rosaro chasing it down against Sosa.
Mosa. Salgado.
Collymore. We're seeing Collymore a lot more coming out for the ball in the second half.
Collymore tries to get ahead to it. Now it's a little Loco. Sends a beautiful pass into Maldonado. Maldonado back tap. Makes the cut. Switching fields into the center. Lays it off for Barbosa. On the far sideline, Barbosa still trying to get it. Oh, and Maldonado got a foot to it. It was a good cross inside. Not strong enough. And Sandor looking to clear.
Yeah, Maldonado was able to take on four of Kennedy's backs and didn't even lose possession before he got the pass off. That's not good defending.
Hello, Loco. stopped by Diaz, and now it's over on the far sideline. Rockwall dealing, wheeling and dealing.
Barbosa's all over the place.
Quito. Solano.
Passing it back to Lipinski. And Lipinski sent it out to the side to Mendez.
And it looked like Lipinski really wasn't expecting to get the ball. Not sure if he wanted to have that one. Solano, it looks like he's been getting open position all game long and really just, I would say, nervous with the ball, doesn't know what to do with it. He tries to get rid of it as soon as he has it, and that's not the case. And if you're going to be at midfield, you have to
looking to distribute, but you could tell he doesn't want to get caught with the ball and lose it. So he's looking for whoever's going to be open, and usually that's the back line, but Lipinski just wants to get it up.
Here's Miranda off the Mendez throw-in.
Sending Rosaro.
And Trevetti is going to have the pickup. And clock still winding down on the Mustangs. Lipinski over the midfield. Heads it back out. Ololoca trying to run it down. Diaz not looking to control it, just trying to get rid of it.
Yeah, just looking to send it out to gain the Kennedy Mustangs some time to reset and organize themselves for this throw-in.
Long throw-in again. These are super throw-ins.
Barrera.
Here's Quito. Quito.
Seselka taking it up the side, trying to get it out.
And he shoves him off. And we saw Quito just fully extend with the left arm on that one, sending Seselka on a little fly, on a trip. Headed out. Osorio somehow got a good touch on that one. Working in their back half. Kicked out of bounds at the 20-yard line. Mendez coming up with it now. Mendez. There's Miranda. Nope.
Rosaro trying to keep it in, sends it across to Lopes. Oh, Rosaro.
Rosaro tripped up from behind. Not sure what that is all about. Free kick, trying to take it quickly. Here's the cross. Miranda, no. Doesn't get a good header to it, but they tried to set up quickly. Catching the Bombers off guard. I think that was a good decision by Rostov.
Good idea trying to catch them with their defense still a little shaken from that last run. Too bad Miranda wasn't able to capitalize on that.
Kennedy, don't go back. Stay up there.
I'm not really sure what we're waiting for at this point.
A lot of balls on the field.
That's an awesome
thing. Didn't quite make sense.
Trevetti sends it up. It's met by Miranda, who heads it over to Lopes. Lopes gets it back. He's looking across. And it goes right through, and it's coming back out. While Osorio tries to clean it up and send it back in again. Gets past his mark. Oh, but he slid from behind. That's going to be a foul in the corner. Mendez sends it through, but it's met by a wall, rock wall.
Out of here!
Out of bounds. Sayreville throwing. Far sideline, center half. Coming over to the midfield. Brooks with it, tripped up. He's got clipped up from behind by either Solano or Osorio on that one, and he's coming up with
by Solano. Solano wasn't ready to move, so we took him down instead. Very lazy defending.
Not fun playing.
Miranda's trying to turn it. Goes to Lopes, who also heads it over the top for Asaro. Comes back out to the midfield, though. Collymore looking back.
Go ahead.
There's going to be a change in goalies here. Michael Phillips is coming in for Trivedi. Yo.
It'd be me, thank you.
Sander punts it, and it's met by Sayreville defender. Collymore is struggling to get Kennedy up. Go, get that ball. Miranda again, looking to switch sides, sends it to Solano. Solano sends it back to Miranda, and they're connecting some passes before they go up as a team, but you see Lipinski looking straight ahead. Goes out for a Kennedy throw.
Up into the center, here's Brooks at the midfield, trying to lay it off to his man, going back to Brooks in the box, and it's wide, going far right. It was a good give and go play on that one. They were slicing and dicing on that one, and it was to no avail, going right of the goal. And now Sandro's gonna try to set up for the kick. Not much time left in this one. There's about 3.5 minutes remaining. Mustangs trailing by 5. You can imagine that they're not going to get out of this hole.
Yeah, each time Sandor or any of the center backs try to clear it and send it up, it's always met by a blue shirt sending it back in, ramming it right back to Kennedy throws.
Mendez trying to get something in here. Mendez off the head. Here's Brooks, who finds it, goes past him. Here's Diaz. Restaro trying to fight with it. Over Gates, running into Salgado. Restaro, the only one showing heart on this team. Here's Osorio on the far sideline, and it'll go out of bounds. He was guarded by one of the defenders.
We always see Restaro using his energy to gain back possession, but he always tries to force it forward, and then he loses it that way.
It looks like he likes to run into people also.
Yeah, he runs into people a lot more than he does with the ball at his feet.
Restaro and Collymore have a tendency to knock their men off, off guard. Here's Soselka, the left back, sends it over to the center half.
Counter attack, coming
it.
Barrera. Sorry, that's Colgan.
Colgan, here's across, Diaz heads it. Back out to Brooks. Colgan trying to do something.
Long
the back
shot.
Line. Bombs away. And we'll see Milton, who trots out onto the field, and Lipinski, we'll see him coming out for the game. Lipinski doing a good job as a center back in a losing effort. comes Osorio.
I think that's the first goal kick that I saw in a while that actually went to a white shirt like it's supposed to.
Yeah. Not many of them have been fought over. Just going to the Sayreville. And now here's Brooks. Good slide tackle by Diaz. Diaz again.
Diaz has been quiet for a while.
And with that, they're going to end the game at 38 minutes. It looks like it was 2 minutes short. But anyway, that's your final score. 4-0 Sayreville coming to Lewis M. Bartha Stadium. 5-0. Dominating over the Mustangs. Any last thoughts?
The Mustangs had very weak opportunities and Sayreville came out strong.
Yep. Mustangs, I felt, didn't really play with too much heart.
Yeah, and then it got weaker and weaker as the game went on. Their energy was dwindling and they didn't have much of a reason to be on the field anymore.
Yeah. All right, final score, 5-0. I'm Stephen Roca. Thanks for Stephen Roca joined alongside by Julianne Roca. Thanks for listening. Okay, guys, you did a good job on the game today. I'm joined here by Maldonado, Trevetti, and Barbosa, two of the goal scorers and the goalkeeper for the Sayreville Bombers. Tell me, what's your overall thoughts on the game, on how you guys played? We'll start with you.
Overall, I think we played well. There are, of course, some things that we need to work on, but we'll do that. And overall, I think I'm happy with their performance so far. And let's just keep going.
Yeah, just like Trevetti said, I think we played very well. We moved the ball great. We do have to work on a couple things, but only the season could get better from here on.
I especially like how we strung a lot of passes together. We also had a lot of hustle, and that was that made this win possible.
Can I just ask you, did you have an arm injury? It looks like you had.
Yeah. I broke my arm a couple months ago.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
And you were wearing a cast. It was.
Yeah. I have a wrap over a brace.
Do you use it to your advantage at all?
Not necessarily. It's kind of a bother, but it doesn't stop.
Okay. And it looks like you guys connected for quite a few goals, a lot of shots. I saw that you had about a 40-yard goal that you let go in the first half. Tell us about that shot.
Well, I saw no one ran to it, so I took the opportunity. I felt composed and just let it rip. Right after it went over the goalkeeper, I knew it was going in.
And then Maldonado, it looks like I'm not sure what the formation is from your coach, but it looks like you're the one piece in the front, and they try to send you forward a lot.
Yeah.
That's the usual strategy.
I like getting the ball fed to me, but I also like when we like string passes together, like work as a team. It's a nice feeling.
And who's your next opponent, coach?
Perth Amboy.
Any preparation that you guys have talked about for the teams in the GMC so far? Expecting anything from Perth Amboy?
Well, we prepare for any team like any other opponent, so there's nothing really different that we do. Just work on the few things that we need to work on and play our best against any opponent. That's really all we do.
Okay, thank you guys. Good luck in your season, all right? And have a good GMC run in the division.